Well, there is a race against time to locate a vessel which went missing while exploring the shipwreck of Titanic. It's been confirmed there are five people who are on board the sub, including a British billionaire. The vessel was last seen 600 k's offshore with a major search effort underway. Our US correspondent, Alison Petrovsky, has the details. Ali, there are hopes of avoiding a second tragedy at the site.
Yeah, that's right. Good morning to you, James. The Boston Coast Guard is leading this very complicated search and rescue mission. It is happening in a very remote part of the Atlantic Ocean, James, hundreds of kilometres off the coast of Newfoundland, where the Titanic sank in 1912. The company, the private company, is called Ocean Gate. They've been running these kind of trips for a couple of years now, where they take tourists down to view the Titanic shipwreck, so more than 3,000 metres down to the ocean floor. The submersible that they get in is called Titan. As you mentioned, five people were on board this time. They lost contact an hour and 45 minutes into their journey. The Coast Guard has just held a press conference a short time ago, James, outlining the efforts they are going to both by air and by sea.
Reached out to the vessel Polar Prince and began a surface search looking for the submersible. At the same time, we launched a C-130 aircraft to search, to conduct an aerial search, both visual and radar of the scene.
The Coast Guard has been stressing that they do have the kind of technology available to see up to 13,000 feet below the surface. As for the five people on board, only one man's identity has so far been revealed, the British billionaire and explorer Hamish Harding. And we know that he was on board because he posted it to social media yesterday, excited about the trip, saying that he was about to go on the only manned mission of 2023, thanks to the worst winter in 40 years, making conditions pretty difficult in that region. He said in a post, "A weather window has just opened up and we are going to attempt a dive tomorrow." James, the submersible has life support designed to last up to 96 hours. They've already been missing for 24. It is 5 o'clock local time there. It will get dark in a few hours. Things will get even more complicated, but we will bring you updates on this throughout the morning.
All crossing our fingers with this one. Ali, thank you.
Well, the US Coast Guard is right now in a race against time for a missing submersible which disappeared during a voyage to the Titanic. Let's bring in CNN anchor and correspondent Paula Newton in Ottawa. Paula, thanks for being with us. It's been confirmed there are five people on board the Canadian vessel.
Yeah, absolutely. Five people. And again, this is a vessel, a submergible. It's about 21 feet long, and it is a special submersible that is designed specifically to go to this depth. And you're talking nearly 2.5 miles, 13,000 feet to the bottom of the sea where this Titanic wreck is. Now, they lost contact with them Sunday afternoon. We are now approaching about 30 hours nearly from when they decided they were going to start this expedition. And the U.S. Coast Guard, which is leading this in conjunction with the Canadian military and Coast Guard, they admit that, look, this is quite a challenge. This is quite a remote area that they will be searching. And a reminder that they're not just searching, you know, the surface of the water, which is difficult enough in that area of the North Atlantic, but they are also trying to search, of course, in the deep sea. Even if they find this vessel, rescuing it is going to be incredibly difficult, as that level of sea bottom, in terms of its depth, that requires a special area of expertise. They are trying to marshal as many resources as they can. That includes trying to basically ask commercial vessels in the area to look as well. They are dealing with about 96 hours, about 4 days. So really, we are looking at less than 3 days that they have to find these five people. We believe that there are two crew and three passengers. And again, this is not like going on a tourism expedition off the coast of Newfoundland to go look at whales. This is a highly specialized expedition. Like exploring space, this is instead exploring the deep seabed, which happens right now to have that Titanic wreck. And these explorers, really intrepid, paid for the privilege to go there, but also said that they were conducting research. Right now, it could be possible that all that happened was that they lost communication and not that they are in jeopardy at the bottom of the sea. This vessel has lost communication in the past, but right now it will take a lot of resources to try and deal with what is an extraordinarily difficult search and rescue right now operation underway in the North Atlantic.
Yeah, let's hope that that is the case, and we'll check in with you over the coming days. Thanks very much for being with us, Paula.
Welcome back. We're taking a look at what's making headlines around the world now, and a desperate search is underway after a vessel used to take tourists to see the wreck of the Titanic went missing in the Atlantic Ocean.
Scary, this one. US correspondent Elsa Matrasky is following the story. Ali, this is a delicate operation.
Yeah, Sarah James, good morning to you. It certainly is. The US Coast Guard is leading this search and rescue mission. They are currently being assisted by Canadian military aircraft, and this is all unfolding in a very remote part of the Atlantic Ocean, more than 640 kilometres off the coast of St. John's, Newfoundland, where the Titanic sank in 1912. The private company called Oceangate had been running these trips for a couple of years, guys, taking tourists down to visit the Titanic shipwreck more than 3 kilometres down on the ocean floor. The submersible that we're watching there, that is what they go down in. It's called the Titan. It can hold as many as 5 people, and we understand in this case there were 5 crew on board, and they lost communications an hour and 45 minutes into their journey down to the shipwreck. A very brief statement from the company so far, just simply saying, we are exploring and mobilising all options to bring the crew back safely. Our entire focus is on the crew members in the submersible and their families. We are working towards the safe return of our crew members. Now, guys, these tours are normally 8-day return trips. They cost more than $365,000. And one person that we know is on board is British billionaire and explorer Hamish Harding, his stepbrother. Confirming the news on social media a short time ago, eerily yesterday, Hamish posted on Facebook saying that this was perhaps going to be the only manned mission down to the shipwreck in 2023 after the worst winter in the region for 40 years. And he eerily said, a weather window has just opened up and we are going to attempt to dive tomorrow. Sarah and James, the submersible has life support for about 96 hours for the crew. They've been missing now for more than 24.
Oh, geez.
Horrible.
All right, Ali, thank you. I want to begin this hour with new details on a major search in the Atlantic Ocean where a tourist vessel exploring the Titanic has disappeared. The US Coast Guard confirming a short time ago 5 people are on board the submersible, which was viewing the wreckage of the famous shipwreck.
The 10-tonne vessel was last seen 600 kilometres offshore. Seats on these submersibles cost up to $250,000 each. The Coast Guard has sent a C-130 Hercules aircraft along with a Canadian P-8 aircraft to search the area from the air.